Morning. Apologies for slurred speech this morning. Can't say my shibboleths. I've been to the dentist, so my mouth's numb. So bear with me. I'm trying to, turning a watercolour. Can you see that? Oops. Into an acrylic painting or an oil painting. It's a totally different thing. I made this one up anyway, it's a watercolour. And I'm going to have a go at it in acrylic. So I'll sketch in the background, bit of a blue. I'll have fairly low horizon. And then a bit stronger. We can refine this as we go along. And we'll have some warmer hills coming in here and right across there. And a bit of lemony yellow with ochre. When you do this, mix the colours, but put some trees on there. Then a bit of that come down here. This is easy to do in watercolour. We're trying to make everything look a bit different. Bear in mind softness and stuff like that. We'll have a really good dark. Come down to there. There's no attempt at a detail at this stage, it's just to put in your masses. And then we'll put in the, put some other stuff in here, just to bring the changes. We don't want anything looking the same, we've got a lot of colour in this. And a nice dark foreground. One there. This is a piece of hardboard that I've primed with that household stuff, filler stuff. Now, I'm just going to put in this nice, it's a matter of opinion, but some loose we can put a bit of a ochre-y, misty stuff in the bottom of that. Right, okay, now we'll put in some water. And then we can, over the water we can put a bleach in and all sorts of stuff in there. So, reflecting this light, a bit of bluey colour. Usually with the watercolour, warm up the whole sheet of paper. I put it soft. Everything soft. I won't put any reflections on the distance because it'd be wind ruffled. Oh, I can't really speak. Okay, so there we can see something going on. Oops, too ochre. Well, there's a touch of blue in that, really. Okay, that's just the basic stuff. Now we'll work on the sky now, so quite a bigger brush now, bigger brush. Attempt to sweep me hot tea, we'll be careful here. I have primed the board with, oh, I did tell you that, didn't I? Right, so we'll just play around. I'll get some white out and palette, and the Stay Wet palette. You know my colours by now, I don't really need to keep going over them. Anybody new to the channel, well, there's loads to look at. So all my information is on somewhere on 800 videos. Right, so let's put in a bit of grey, just to start with. I don't follow any pattern. It's just a case of getting something down, mix a little bit of water. Just to get a bit of colour on there. I'm using some water just to thin it down so we can cover it quickly, otherwise we'll be able to clean. It will add another bit of waterproofing to the surface. Bit of red in there, eh? Just warm it up. I don't really want a red sky or yellow to compete with that. I might change that. You can be all soft, but merge your edges. And you can paint back into them. I'll just scumble over that. A bit more there. It being acrylic, it's plastic. Just thickening up everything now. Okay, now we're putting a bit of darky bluey stuff. Let's mix in some vermilion with this. Because there's light there, we'll put dark over, similar to sky, so we did yesterday. I'm just mixing blue and a bit of vermilion. That's dark. Now some light red mixed in with that. So let's have a bit of a stormy sky. Now we can put in a bit reflecting some dry brush, reflecting the ripples, light and dark. They get in the way, don't they? Right, okay, let's keep working at that. Well, it's going to be sticky now. So I'll go back onto the land. My screen's just vanished. Oh, anybody struggling with Windows 10 update? I've lost my picture now. I'll come back. It took about 2 hours to update last night. Sweet tea. Oh, sorry about slurping, but my mouth and tongue are still pretty numb. Okay. That's a bit of blue. Yes. Bring that over there. I can't emphasise the softness about everything. Put a bit of cloud in there. Right, okay. Not happy with that shape, but right, let's go underneath that now with this nice sienna and lemon yellow. But mix your colours on, what I mean is lots of colour in this. Catching some sun here, maybe. Contrasting with the dark sky. Okay, I like that. Now a bit of grey here, a bit of warm grey. Some lighter colour in that. Right, let's go on to the other side now. We've got this nice peak here. I'm going to mix up a colour for that. So maybe a bit of black. A bit of black with a bit of red, a bit of blue. All the way down to that bit there. So we've got our darkest bit against the lightest bit of the sky at the moment. Fill those holes. Now we can put in some lights and greens. Bit of black, bit of yellow. Something like that green, just a bit of need some detail in that there, so I'll put that in a bit of a sienna-y red, mixture some brighter colours. Just making it up, I'm just having fun with the paint. Now we want some dark in there now. So black, mid yellow, some trees coming down here. We can put some lights on them later. That's a really lovely rich green. I can see that on my palette. But in the light, there is the mixture of the black, the mid-yellow and this burnt sienna, or you can use the vermilion. You get a lovely, deep, rich green. And I want some of that on the other side as well. But let's put in some here. Put some in here, just balance it up a bit. I can make some of these light with some lighter canopies, just catching the sunlight. A little bit of blue with that, I think. Of course, it's just a bit further back, this one. Okay, what we're doing is just making a, trying to make a pretty picture. Right, a bit of blue, a bit of yellow into that previous mix. Oh, we can put some, following the line of the land, just these trees. Something like that, that's a bit clashed a bit there. And we'll put some really nice dark ones on here. Alright, that looks a bit naff, doesn't it? But I'll change that as I work into it with the sky. I want to add some bit of interest in this peak, just catching just putting some nondescript greys, just catching like rocks and okay, something's happening there. Right, a bit of tea. Now I'm gonna put some lights back in here, just a little bit, just catching. Okay, and we can put a bit of shadow back in that one. And just a bit catching the light on. There. And a bit of light blue. Back in there. Painting is limitless. I wouldn't say I've got a particularly good imagination, because we can all do different things. You can give 20 people something to copy, and the same paints, same materials, and they'll all do something different. Well, let me put a little bit of darker blue in there. This is show a bit of shadow in the here and there. Right, okay. Right, we go back to the sky now. Right, let's get this, see if we're going to get a decent colour for the sky. I think light red is proving to be, I used to love it, but I don't seem to be getting on with it at the moment. Well, let's just put some clouds real across here now. Change this, it's just too much of a muddy colour. So let's use primaries here. I have a frame, an old frame, for this to go in, if it ever reaches the... Now, where the light ray comes in very handy is in light clouds. Now, make your clouds of silver, not of lead. Oops. There's water coming out of the ferrule with this brush. Yeah, all the challenges we have. Let's get that one across here. There's lots of colour in this now. Clouds are never white. They have lots of lovely colours in them. So you use four times as much white as anything else. Oh, let's just get that. So it's very similar to what I did day, but I want some really good dark, but I want it blue rather than muddy red, and probably a bit of vermilion would be a better red to use. Yeah, no. So a bit of drama, go for it, Dave. I'm mixing vermilion with the blue, with the ultramarine, so I can go back into that with some light and see what happens. Getting into my stride now, so let's. So, yellow ochre, red, light red, and white. A bit of impasto. Still the same colours, but lots of white. Just putting some variety back in these. Bit of red in there, don't like that. Take that out. Sign. Well, I've softened everything now. Now put a little bit of detail back in the sky, that is. Bit of dark. Just little bits of. You see, you can work at this forever and ever, but you have to call a halt sooner or later. Right, I just want to put that, some light back there to make that one smaller than the one above it, well, obviously smaller than the one above it. So, my red and my yellow. What does that look like? Well, that looks quite reasonable, isn't it? Now we go back and do some water now before we start going back on those edges of the cliff, the hills, mountains. A bit of water. I'm going to put some of those colours back there, but as I said earlier, reflections, I don't mean mirror images. we want to put those colours in, but just dry brush, just dragged over there. And we've got this just gently putting those colours into the water. We've got this nice dark mix. Now let's just gently put that back there. Cloud, a bit of shadow. Okay. Now back with the water, and there's some highlights on that water. I'm going to do some here, some reflection here. But I'm still using this larger brush. That's hard to get diffused on there, so we'll let that go. Now some light catching on there, so a bit of lemon yellow, So I'm just trying to, just by using some light dragged over this, I'm just breaking up the obvious shapes. Bit of light coming down there. We can get even a bit more there. Lemon yellow, bit of yellow ochre. That's a bit hard there. Let's just soften that a little bit. Right, okay, so that's that. Now I'll put these reflections in the ripples. That's what we'll be careful of. Then we've got to think about this foreground. But I think you do foregrounds, do them as quick as you can, because you're looking there, not down here. So I'm going to use a big brush for that. There we go. Just find picture, there it is. Well, I'll give you a glimpse of what we're doing. Could you see that's what we're doing? We're not copying it exactly. I hope it doesn't fall off. Right, I'll put in some black, some red. This is going to be my beach. Don't panic. We'll just drag over bits of stuff on there. Just put a bit here. just bits of beach. Just dragging some variety across that. Now some rocks in there. It's a bit of white. Just have some nondescript greys here. It's a bit of knife. Okay. We can put in some dark on there in a minute, just to show some shadows. I'm missing some blue and red here, just for some shadows. For the rocks. They're not really shining, are they? Well, they're supposed to be rocks, but they're not. Right. I'll put a rigger and we'll put in some detail. This is easier to do in watercolour, this sort of stuff. So we put up, put down. Just some little boats on there. Not much I'm going to do. I'll put a couple of little birds. Thank you. We'll call it Lakeland. Not convinced about that, but I think we've spent enough time on it. I'll put it in the frame. And I'll just change the angle of that so it doesn't fall over. Right, okay. Bear with me a minute while I get the paint all over my shorts. Right, there we go. So there it is, a demonstration of Lakeland painting using a watercolour as a base. I don't think it looks too bad. Any comments, leave them. I hope you enjoyed that. Thanks for watching. I've done it as roughly as I can. Sorry about my speech is worse than usual. See you soon. Bye-bye.